I know what you're thinking. How the heck does a 52-year-old, over-the-hill, milkshake machine salesman build a fast food empire with 1,600 restaurants at an annual revenue of $700 million? One word. Persistence.
Prince Castle Sales.
Hi, Jim.
Ray, how's it going down there?
Good. Swell. A lot of interest.
We got an order. 6 mixers.
To anyone in particular?
McDonald's.
Care for a little tour?
We wanted something different,
and that's when my brother here comes up with one of his brilliant ideas.
Orders ready in 30 seconds, not 30 minutes.
Unique, original, there's nothing like this.
It's revolutionary.
That's exactly what it is, it's revolutionary. What is that?
The Golden Arches.
It's a way to make the place stand out.
Huh. There should be McDonald's everywhere. Franchise the damn thing.
Mr. Kroc.
Franchise, franchise, franchise.
McDonald's can be the new American church. And it ain't just open on Sundays, boys.
I am flesh and I am bone. Rise up, ting, ting, like glitter and gold.
How can we be almost out of capital?
Did you mortgage our home?
Maybe we could lose everything.
I want to renegotiate my lousy deal.
I can't.
Can't or won't?
Ray.
What?
No!
Oh, damn it.
What you ought to be doing is owning the land upon which that burger is cooked. You're not in the burger business. You're in the real estate business.
Franchise Realty Corporation.
It's its own separate company, which puts it outside your purview.
There's a wolf in the hen house. We let him in.
When's enough gonna be enough for you?
Probably never.
You are to stop this instant.
I am through taking orders from you.
You have a contract!
Contracts are like hearts. They're made to be broken. Business is war. It's dog eat dog, rat eat rat. I want to take the future. I want to win.
The brothers are your business partners.
Make it go away. I don't care what it takes.
That glorious name, McDonald's. I had to have it.
You don't have it.
You sure about that?
I thought I knew a lot of things about Ray Kroc, and it turns out I knew almost nothing. And the origin of McDonald's. But, you know, when you see a really good script, you know it. And then you had seen the director, if you've seen the director's work, you got that information. And so after a meeting or two with John, I went, yeah, this is a guy I'd like to work with. He didn't start this until he was in his 50s. You know, he had his ups and downs. He had years where he did quite well, and then years where he wasn't doing well at all. And he had been working since he was a teenager, you know, dropped out of school and a couple times, and then said, he was very clear, said, I want to go into business, I want to make money, and I want to do that now. And he started and did okay, did very well, then did maybe not so well, and was like life is, especially life in show business. And he put his, you know, his head down and went for it, and he was driven. And it's really the story of the free enterprise system and capitalism and America at that time. I've had some great good fortune, and this one's no less. I've been in some great casts, and this is a really great cast. John Lynch and Nick Offerman, who were so fabulous, These guys are so good. The first day they showed up, they had speeches like this. And I thought, well, you know, this will be several takes because we got to come in and, you know, cut it into pieces. Did a couple, sat down in rehearsal, and they, boom, right through it. Okay, let's see if they can do this when they shoot it. I don't know if they had been like sneaking off and rehearsing for weeks, but they were word perfect first day. At one point, I forgot my line. I forgot to come in because I was so mesmerized by how good they were. It changed it immensely. It arguably is the first example of branding, you know, by imagery anyway. You know, I mean, it created this this image. You know, he saw the visual. You know, he visually saw the arches and the colors and it obviously saw way beyond that. It saw what it could be, and it's ubiquitous, if that's the correct word. It's a thing that is been through your life, whether you've even eaten in a McDonald's or not, it doesn't matter. It's a thing that is interwoven into the society, you know what I mean? Starbucks is that now, you know? It's just, you could reference McDonald's in a lot of ways and never having stepped foot in one, you know? And it changed the way, arguably, the way we live. You know, we're a portable society. We're a throwaway society. We're a fast-moving society, you know. I mean, it's a great American story. It really is. It's just a really well-made movie, too. It's just a well-made movie and entertaining as hell. It has a bit of a Billy Wilder feel to it, actually.
One, I didn't know much about the beginnings of McDonald's, so when I read the script, I was really shocked to find out the true story. Two, when I read the script, Rob Siegel's script, I was quite taken by the idea that I was pulling actively for Ray Kroc at the start of it, and then toward the end was at best ambivalent about his approach to business. And so I thought that's fascinating. I'd never read a script like that before where is he a hero? Is he a villain? Is he a good guy? Is he a bad guy? And it's kind of a Rorschach test for viewers, I think. I think there are certain attributes that he shares with Ray Kroc. I think they're both Midwestern kind of guys. They're both hardworking guys. Neither one of them was given a financial leg up in the world. And they both have kind of a forward lean, and I think that's the similarities. I think that the similarities probably, perhaps, end there, but I think Michael was just fantastic. There's something, Michael is great at playing someone who needs you to believe. He's great at playing a desperation and a desire for something. But he's also such a talented actor that he can go to the dark, quiet places for you, too. He was just, it's amazing. We had tons of conversations, and I thought I knew the journey we were going to be on, and he did too, and we would clock each other and check in with each other all the time, but I was just continually amazed at what he was bringing to it that we hadn't discussed. I think it's just a fabulous cast, and they were so much fun to work with. They're all so talented. I mean, starting off with the McDonald's brothers, with John Carroll Lynch and Nick Offerman, I was looking for round-shouldered American guys, and I think they fit the bill, and I don't know, I'm just such a fan of both of them, and to see them work together just was magic. And I think when you threw yet another energy in with Michael, you had three different energies in a room together when they were there, and they made for a really interesting stew. Linda Cardellini, Laura Dern, of course, you know, hard to beat Laura Dern. She's fantastic. Linda Cardellini is someone that I admired her work for a while, and so thankfully she came and joined us. Patrick Wilson is somebody that I cast in The Alamo way back when, and that's when I first met Patrick, and he's just such a fine actor. But they all are. Everybody we have in this movie is just, it's wonderful. Kate Nealand, everybody from big roles to small roles, everybody was fantastic. It's interesting because I think Michael's pointed out that Kroc may have been kind of the first branding machine, if you will, because he had the understanding of the iconic brand and the sales tool that was, as well as the name being a sales tool. He understood that McDonald's Brothers didn't understand it. He understood it, that there was value in that. One of the interesting things to me was about how commerce and capitalism has changed. I think it used to be the McDonald's Brothers brand, which is have a great idea, work hard, do it yourself, show up every day, take pride in your work. And I think the other side of capitalism that we've kind of shown in this movie a bit is it's not so much about having a good idea. Yeah, you might have to work hard, but more importantly, know the right investment bankers. So I think that's kind of the other side of it.
McDonald's.
Just found a way to save you, me, and all our owner-operators literally hundreds of dollars a year in electric
And what
costs.
Would that be?
Two words, powdered milkshake. I'm telling you, I came across a remarkable product called Instamix. Like I say, it's a powdered milkshake. It's a fraction of the cost of ice cream and requires no refrigeration.
Ray.
I'm telling you, I tried it myself. It tastes just like the real thing.
It's delicious. It comes in chocolate, comes in vanilla. Me, I'm a vanilla man.
Ray, we have no interest in a milkshake that contains no milk. Why don't we add sawdust to the hamburgers while we're at it? Frozen French fries.
You don't want to save a bundle.
Not like that.
We're talking about
the same great taste. Same great taste while boosting the bottom line.
It's called a milkshake, Ray.
Real milk.
Now and forever.
I understand. I'm going to give you three words. I want you to take those three words home with you tonight. McDonald's is family. Isn't that great? You know what I say when I say that? Family. We're one big family. Aren't we? You have mouths to feed. That's a family. I'm looking for a few good men and women
who aren't afraid of hard work, aren't afraid to roll up their sleeves.
It's cliche, I know, but
I'm looking for scrappers, hustlers, guys who are willing to roll up their sleeves.
People with a little drive.
They got a little fire in the belly.
Got a little chutzpah.
I stand right here before you today, and I'm going to offer you something as precious as gold. You know what that is?
Anybody?
Anybody? Opportunity.
It's opportunity.
Opportunity. Opportunity to advance.
To move forward. To move up. To advance. To succeed. To win.
To step up.
The sky's the limit.
Sky's the limit.
Grab the brass ring.
To give yourself a shot at the American dream.
Put your arms around the American dream.
Opportunity.
Because I'll tell you something.
At McDonald's,
just like this great nation of ours,
some of that elbow grease.
I guarantee you.
If you've got the guts,
you got the gumption,
you got the desire,
I guarantee you, you can succeed.
There's gold to be had
at the end of
those golden arches.
Golden arches.
Golden arches.
Now, who's with me?
Who wants to jump on that ladder to success?
Become part of the McDonald's Spucha.
Now, who's with me?
You know, I drove through a lot of towns, a lot of small towns. And they all had two things in common. They had a courthouse and they had a church. On top of the church, got a cross. And on top of the courthouse, they'd have a flag. Flags, crosses, crosses, flags. Driving around, I just cannot stop thinking about this tremendous restaurant. Now, at the risk of sounding blasphemous, forgive me. Those arches have a lot in common with those buildings. A building, well, a cross on top, what is that? It's a gathering place where decent, wholesome people come together and they share values protected by that American flag. It could be said that that beautiful building flanked by those arches signifies more or less the same thing. It doesn't just say delicious hamburgers inside. They signify family. It signifies community. It's a place where Americans come together to break bread. I am telling you, McDonald's can be the new American church, feeding bodies and feeding souls, and it ain't just open on Sundays, boys.
So, to summarize, you have a minuscule revenue stream, no cash reserves, and an albatross of a contract that requires you to go through a slow approval process to enact changes, if they're approved at all, which they never are. Am I missing anything?
That about sums it up.
Tell me about the land.
The land.
The land, the buildings, how that whole aspect of it works.
Oh, pretty simple, really. Franchisee finds a piece of land he likes, gets a lease, usually 20 years, takes out a construction loan, throws up a building, and off he goes.
So the operator selects the site.
Yeah.
He picks the property.
Right.
You provide the training, the system, the operational know-how, and he is responsible for the rest.
Is there a problem?
A big one. You don't seem to realize what business you're in. You're not in the burger business. You're in the real estate business.